Global students, well, I wanted in this video to introduce you, just give you an overview of the course, also give you a sense for how the course is going to be managed. So let's just talk about how the course will be run or managed. Now, I'm dividing all the content in terms of weekly folders. So for each week, there'll be a folder: week one, week two, week three, and week four. And in each week's folder, the first video would be something called titled tasks and deliverables for the week. So that will tell you exactly, you know, what to do for that week. Also tell you what assignment is due when. Okay, so usually we'll have all our assignments due on a Sunday. So that's the first video you want to watch when you open a certain week's folder. Okay, so in this course, we're trying to give you a sense for how different countries are connected, whether it's through financial flows, through trade flows, through flows of people across countries. And so I want to give you a sense of that in this course. And so the hook for this course then is something called, and so the question for you is, well, why should I care? You know, why should I care how different countries are connected, whether, you know, people are able to move across borders, or if, you know, if there's money flowing from one country to another, how does that impact me? Why should I care? So the hook for this course is something called a personal strategic plan. And the reason I'm trying to use this device as a hook for this course is because you will use something called a strategic plan, or you will come across a strategic plan more and more often as you move through the business school and in other courses as well. So it's good to get familiar with this idea, you know, early on. And what this personal strategic plan does, I'll have an example in your in the information folder as well. So make sure you take a look at that. So it gives you sort of a sense of, you know, well, what are these different global forces that will impact me, and then what can I do about them? Can I sort of be proactive and make myself sort of competitive in the labor market? So what I mean is, as you work towards graduation, let's say, you know, with a business degree, or let's say an accounting major, right? You come up with an accounting degree. The question is, are you competing with students from, say, just IU, Purdue, Ball State, or are you competing with graduates in, say, India or in other countries? And so that's sort of the question. And we'll see increasingly you're competing with not just graduates here in Indiana or in the U.S., but also graduates across the globe. And so the question then is, how do you keep yourself competitive in this kind of global labor market? And so this personal strategic plan will let you at least help you will get you sort of thinking about how you should plan for your own future as you move through your courses and move towards graduation. So that's sort of one piece of this course. And a quick sort of, you know, again, an overview of this course in terms of the global forces. You know, we look again, as I said, as how technology is changing. You know, we talk about technology, what that means, and how is that changing the landscape in terms of the kinds of opportunities it's creating, but also the kinds of jobs that it's eliminating. So the whole job mix is changing because of technology. Well, what do I mean by that? People will talk about technology. What does that mean? It means lots of things, and you'll see that in your materials. But, you know, one example, of course, is internet. As the internet speeds and so on, becomes downloading speeds and become faster, as it becomes easier and easier to quote unquote send batches of jobs to other parts of the country. Let's say you're a software programmer, or you have a software company here in Evansville, and you're finding, where can I find, you know, you're just a startup company, you don't have lots of cash reserves on hand, so you're trying to find people who can do the same quality job at perhaps a lower price. So maybe you have, say, you know, a programmer in India do some work, so another programmer in Poland do another piece of work. And then maybe have a project manager here based in Evansville, then coordinates all these different programs spread all through the world. So again, as technological change is making more and more of this possible, as you can now communicate, whether it's, you know, not just through email, but you know, all kinds of, whether it's FaceTiming, Skype, all these other technologies where you can see each other and communicate and so on. So that's changed the mix of jobs. In other words, you might have fewer jobs for entry-level programmers here in the U.S., but you might have jobs for, say, higher level in terms of, you know, project managers. So it's changing those sort of mix of jobs. And so we'll look at that in terms of one of the global forces. Another force that we'll look at is institution. That is, we'll talk about what that means. But let's say you're wanting to work not just here but in some other countries as well, or you want to invest in other countries. It's like we said, financial flows. Then what kinds of institutions are crucial or important that you should pay attention to? And when we talk, and we'll define institutions and so on later on. But what kinds of laws in those countries you should be aware of, and that will help you get a better return on your investment, those kinds of things. And what kinds of countries, is it still those, the what used to be called the BRIC countries, that where you should put your money in? That's Brazil, Russia, India, China, or are there other what so-called, quote-unquote, what have been called breakout nations that maybe you should be thinking about in terms of where to do your investing and maybe even look for job opportunities. So that's the other global force we'll look at. The other thing is also this global force of increasing income inequality in the world. You know, you've probably heard this phrase: richer getting richer, and the poor are not moving up the income ladder. So you know, the question is how do you not stay in this bottom rung of the income ladder? What do you do to sort of get up there so that you don't get stuck in this bottom income ladder? So we'll look at this global force and the implications that has as well. So the question was then, how do you, you know, all these different global forces, you know, I could teach them just by themselves, but that wouldn't sort of wouldn't be personal to you, and hence we have this device of the personal strategic plan that helps for you get a personal stake in why you should understand how these global forces work. So that's a quick sort of overview of this course and how the course is managed and why you should care about global economic issues.